The phrase ready for sea obviously is the Navy Supply Corps' motto. The Navy dominates the world when it comes to the control of the seas, the safe navigation and passage within the seas, and logisticians and Supply Corps officers, whether they be ashore, whether they be in an administrative type facility, whether they be fleet service support, contracting, BSOs that deal with fuel, any and all of that ultimately enables us to be the world's greatest Navy, the world's most powerful and most flexible Navy, and ultimately our job is to enable us to be ready for sea.
We are warrior servants. We are enablers. Our job as Supply Corps officers is to set the landscape for success, ensure that we have everything we need, all the resources necessary for success, and we sustain the fight, and we're ready to fight tonight. And that's powerful.
Our enemy has become incredibly skilled, much more capable. We are losing our strategic advantage throughout the world. We are having to rethink the way we fight our fights, and we're having to integrate within the interagency and within the services much more effectively in order to maintain that competitive advantage and thwart any progress by our enemies.
We're in high demand right now. A lot of what we're doing strategically as a nation that goes down to strategically as a Navy, a lot of it is going to be enabled through logistics. And then I think a lot of our warfighting, you know, flag officers and general officers in the Pentagon understand that logistics is what's going to bring us to the fight.
We provide a lot of flexible logistics. And with that flexible logistics, people see what we're capable of doing. We come up with innovative solutions. It puts more pressure on us because people want more of what we bring to the table.
The visibility of our assets, whether it's ordnance, whether it's parts, whether it's even buildings, we need to know what we have when we have it. How much does it cost? What's the value? What's the condition? Everything so that we can maintain mission readiness at all times. Audit is an opportunity for us to do business better. And that's what we should look at audit. It's not about someone coming in trying to, I got you. No, it's not that. It's about looking at how we're doing business today and how can we make it better.
We can get to that standardized process where we've got transparency, we've got predictability, and we kind of understand, we've got clarity in how our systems link together, how our processes interface and link together. That can only help to improve, you know, how our forecasting, both in material forecasting as well as our budget forecasting, how those come together.
The benefit of auditability is we know the budget's tight. The budget's not getting better. There's not going to be any reprieve. So any dollar we can find, save, or do something through auditability gives us more flexibility in the warfighter to pay for a capability or invest in a capability with your need for the fight in the future.
We're getting increasing signals that, you know, we need to get more into the industrial side of things.
We're looking to put supply officers back in the shipyards and back in the FRCs to kind of get that oversight. And
it's not enough that we have it on the shelf in the warehouse back CONUS. We've got to be creative, understand not only the commercial, but the military lines of transportation by each of our service. So not just the Navy, look at the Army, Navy, Air Force, see who has direct flights and what capabilities we have and how can we get it there. Embrace the solution and find that.
I think the biggest way that we help support improving readiness and lethality is the expertise that our community, and that includes our civilians, our supply enlisted, and our officer corps, that we bring to the organizations that we're part of. As they're focused on readiness and lethality, so are we. And then we can leverage the network of the supply community to help improve things, to break down barriers. And I think that our focus with respect to alignment with the warfighter is always laser focused, and I think that's something that Admiral Skubic, as our Commander Navy Supply Systems Command and Chief of Supply Corps, has continued to stress. And so, with her having it as a priority, we all collectively have it as a priority. We're able to break down some of those barriers. I think one thing that our community brings to the equation is creativity and innovation and how we solve problems. And the ability to learn and leverage each other to help, you know, create better solutions.
We don't fight alone. We can't fight alone. We need to understand not only how our fellow United States Navy DOD services work, function, and operate, but also how our NATO allies, our allies in the Pacific, how they operate. So not only is it joint, but it's international. And that's why exercises such as RIMPAC, Valiant Shield, Talisman Sabre are critically important, because we're building relationships and we're building a shared understanding of how our partners operate, and we're finding those gaps and seams so that if we do have to fight, we can fight together to win.
And it's interesting, you know, working on the joint staff, everyone recognizes a supply officer. They know the pork chop, they know the supply leaf, they come up, and it's interesting, they know a lot about our community. And typically they ask questions. They want to understand how we do business.
We took an oath. All of us took an oath. That's fundamentally different than every nation in the world. We swear to support and defend. That is ready for sea, is defending the Constitution, defending the nation, and the power that the Navy brings in that great power competition, where we can project power all over the world.